which I'm going to consider just now is a bit different. Mm-hmm. It's just your comment about functional setting of problems in mechanics. So I want to also to give comment on this comment.
Okay.
So plate. Let us consider Kirchhoff plate. In a polygonal domain, so omega is something of this type. I draw such picture. The plate is clamped. Sorry, the plate is fixed. Edge of the plate is fixed, and it is simply supported so that on the boundary we have the following condition. This means that there is no bending of the plate, and this means that momentum is zero. And such conditions are used in mechanics in order to describe something which lays like a covering on the edge of some hole. In principle, it's a simple linearization of Signorini conditions, which are one-sided conditions, and this is a questionable if it's correct or not. But they are widely accepted, and I'm not going to discuss mechanical sense of this mm-hmm. problem. In many cases, they are these conditions are good. So, since boundary consists of straight lines, there is no additional term which appear in case of curved boundaries. In case of curved boundaries, you have to consider something like there is a coefficient, I don't remember it, curvature and derivative along the normal. But curvature here is zero, so this term disappears. This problem appeared in very interesting situation. It was rather long time ago. I worked at that time with Mazia. Yes.
There is no hidden condition in the vertexes.
We will discuss this later.
Okay.
So in principle, this problem is uniquely solvable, and there is no need for additional conditions.
Okay.
But of course, there are something related to angles. Angle, corner are very make problem very sensitive to formulation in spaces, to dress it in these spaces. So at the time I was working with Mazia and some engineers from Odessa, it's a town now in Ukraine and before in USSR, they asked him for following question. They had a program which solves directly a problem for Laplace equation. And by trivial substitution, namely, let us call minus Laplacian of u v. By trivial substitution, this problem is reduced to the iterated Laplacian. Namely, it's minus delta w is equal to f w. W is a new notation for u. Is equal to zero in omega. On the omega. This problem has unique solution. You solve it, obtain W. Sorry, V here. V. And then you can solve due to this renotation this problem for W and arrive at a solution. So this is plate problem, this is iterated Laplacian problem. They found, making calculations, that their results were completely different with experiment, so no relation at all. So that in experiment, the plate goes down here, the plate goes up, and I'm going to investigate the situation. If u is equal to v or not. So, rather strange question, because it's a simple renotation of unknown functions. The answer is no. And I would like to explain why. Okay. First, simple explanation. Both solutions here lives in H1. This problem is uniquely solvable in Sobolev space H1, which means that this integral is bounded. V and W. But this problem is solved in H2. Which means that integral over omega u, gradient u, and second gradient, collection of second order derivative, bounded. This guy, of course, is equivalent to the energy, elastic energy of this plate. So, and of course, everything is hidden here. Here we search for a solution in H2, and here we find the solution in H1. What is important is that this problem has two different settings. One is in H1, and one is in H2. Here we have u in H2, Laplacian u in L2, according to this. And here we have w in H1, and v, which is minus delta minus v, which is Laplacian w, belongs to H1 as well. And of course, this difference appears not every time, but for concave domains. If there is concave angle, like I draw on the picture, then this is the there is different setting. If domain is if polygon is convex, then solution satisfies. Solutions coincide both. I would like to say that this trivial transform of one problem to other problem happens rather plenty times in my life when I get a paper to make a referee report on it. So I remember three papers with such mistake. Usually, for example, for cracks or for angular domains, it's worth to introduce potentials, just to reduce elasticity problem to scalar equations or something like this. And in many times, this introduction of potentials lead to misunderstanding in which space the final problem must be solved. So, I know several, at least two situations where this mistake was published, let me say. So, and what's interesting is that reaction of mechanicians on this thing is much more exciting than one can imagine, mathematician can imagine. They call it as a paradox. So if such transformation is performed by eyes, evidently one can see that they are equivalent. And if they are not equivalent, this is a paradox. And this paradox has several names. For example, paradox of Kostrov, it has just this nature. Okay, but those are words, and I would like to explain what happens. To do so, I first need to investigate this problem quite deep. So here, remember our main goal, and now we start with formulations of the problem. I forgot to say one thing, which is of very interesting application. It's my recent result with Guido Swirz from Delft University of Technology. The result is the following, that if we have convex domain of this type, then there is a positivity property, so that if right-hand side f is positive, then u is positive. And this follows from from even strictly positive. This follows from the positivity property of Laplacian. From maximum principle, it follows that if right-hand side is positive, solution of the Laplace equation with the Dirichlet boundary condition is positive inside domain. Since our problem can be reduced to iterated Laplacian, applying twice this principle, you get this consequence for positive domain, for convex domain. For non-convex domain, we have proved that this is not true for these angles between 2 pi and 2 pi over 3. So for theta, for angles between pi and 0, it's yes. This is no. There exist examples when positivity is lost. So the force F everywhere is positive, but for negative.
Yeah.
And the, but solution, but plate goes up in some sense. It's not complicated thing to imagine this. For example, this plate, you push here and this goes in other direction. It's understandable. But nevertheless, the whole gap from pi to 3 pi, it's an open problem. We don't know. We tried several times, but we fall through to construct an example. Also,
also this case you draw, it's open problem still.
Sorry?
In reality it does, but also this case as proof, the case of that drawing.
This? Yes. This is but numerical evidence shows that it's okay. What is interesting that for angles of this type, and suppose that you have concentrated load here, the negative part is somewhere here, even in such way.
Yeah.
So it is a question of singularity. But if angle becomes, sorry, vice versa, it's just a case, yes. But if angle is between, belongs to this semi-interval, then it's interesting, again, that it's here. Mm-hmm. The negative zone. At a distance from the corner. So it is not a question of singularity. It's a question of other type. But what I'm going to present now during this lecture is just singularity analysis. Singularity means the problem different. I am going to consider only one point of with the opening of the angle larger than pi, so the concave cone. But of course, everything can be easily generalized for many concave angles. By the way, concerning the question of these engineers from Odessa, they were considering the plate of this type. It's a square with a hole of square shape inside. It was just a covering for something in one ship. What was interesting that we find solution, we give a correct way of solving this problem, but the answer was incredible. They say that, oh, thank you very much. Now they even pay some money to us. Oh, thank you very much. We are very happy. We now know that our algorithm doesn't work, but nevertheless, we still will solve the problem with our algorithm. It's easier. Okay, but it doesn't. Now let us consider the following problem, the following domain. It's some angle. So everywhere its domain is convex with the exception of one point. And we introduce here polar coordinates so that locally domain is given by this inequality. Let us consider first Laplace equation with the Dirichlet Poisson equation with the Dirichlet boundary condition. Again, with reference to Fourier method, I would like to write down asymptotic form of solution. I refer too much to Fourier method because it works properly for Laplacian, but it is not okay for elasticity, for example. But nevertheless, there exist other theory by Kondratiev and Mazia Plamenevsky, so it was developed maybe 20 years ago in Russia and in France mainly. So I also have to mention books of Grivar in this direction. But
Grivar,
yes, but he, as was I was explained.
Yeah, pronunciation is Grivar.
Without S, Grivar. So, if you look for this function, it is a harmonic. It is a harmonics with zero Dirichlet boundary conditions.
So, origin is just in the singular.
Yes. This is just in the thing. Really, this is a harmonic because R in power lambda sin lambda phi is harmonic for any lambda. And here lambda is taken pi over theta in order to satisfy on both sides homogeneous Dirichlet conditions. This function is harmonics as well. What is the difference between these two functions? This function lives in H1 of omega. And this lives in H2 of omega only, not in H1. I would like to comment on this. So what does it mean that function lives in H1? It means that its gradient is square of gradient is integrable in omega. So we have r pi over theta minus 1. This is the order of gradient. We differentiate this function once. Then we multiply this 2. We take square of it. And we write the integral from 0 to 1 r dr. This is Jacobian on the plane, and this is integration. So then we have that this integral converges if and only if and indeed it is convergent. Because here we have this is equal to 2 pi over theta. And this is a positive number. If we do the same with this function, we need to change here plus for minus. So we get minus, here minus, and this is wrong because the opposite is true. So this function is in H1, this function is not in H1. Well, this function has finite Dirichlet integral, this not. But this function is in L2. And how to conclude this is just to consider the same situation. R minus 2 pi over theta r dr. And so minus 2 pi over theta plus 2 must be positive for this inclusion to be true. And this is okay because then pi, this means that pi smaller than theta. And it was just our assumption that the angle is larger than pi. So the angle is concave. So we have these two functions. Just to finish explanation about singularities, I would like to say a bit more about this is, those are harmonics. But also we have biharmonics. I'm not sure that it's necessary to write in such a way. My computer shows that it's necessary to put here some slash. So we have this sine pi over theta pi. We have this. It's possible to verify that these two functions are biharmonic and satisfy this condition, U and Laplacian U is equal to zero on the sides of the corner. But also we have this. This function is generated by this one, namely we solve this equation again. In order to get this function. And if we put here minus, we get this function. And there is a competition between these four functions. We need to choose two of them which form a solution. So if we solve the problem in H2, and if theta is greater than pi, then this function for sure is in H2, and this function as well. It's possible to verify. For this function, it's clear. For this function, Laplacian of this function belongs to is equal to this, and this is in L2. So for concave, these two things are for concave corner. For concave corner, these two functions form a solution. But if angle is convex, then other functions belong to H2. Now this function doesn't belong to H2, but this one and this one. Those are for this case. While solving Laplace equation, this function appears. We will see. And so now we see the change. If angle is convex, then it's just solving of Laplace equation. But if angle is concave, then asymptotic of solution is formed by harmonic function. These two functions are not harmonics. So there is no possibility to solve directly. So this is the comment, but now we need to investigate the Dirichlet problem. For our pleasure. If we apply Fourier method, we will see that solution can be decomposed at least, for example, f is equal to zero in the vicinity of the angle, can be decomposed in this vicinity, in the neighborhood of the tip of the angle, in the series of such harmonics. This is nothing but to also to give comment on this comment. Okay. So, plate. Let us consider Kirchhoff plate. In a polygonal domain, so omega is something of this type. I draw such picture. The plate is clamped. Sorry, the plate is fixed. Edge of the plate is fixed, and it is simply supported so that on the boundary we have the following condition. This means that there is no bending of the plate, and this means that momentum is zero. And such conditions are used in mechanics in order to describe something which lays like a covering on the edge of some hole. In principle, it's a simple linearization of Signorini conditions, which are one-sided conditions, and this is a questionable if it's correct or not. But they are widely accepted, and I'm not going to discuss mechanical sense of this problem. In many cases, they are these conditions are good. So, since boundary consists of straight lines, there is no additional term which appear in case of curved boundaries. In case of curved boundaries, you have to consider something like there is a coefficient, I don't remember it, curvature and derivative along the normal. But curvature here is zero, so this term disappears. This problem appeared in very interesting situation. It was rather long time ago. I worked at that time with Mazia. Yes.
There is no hidden condition in the vertexes.
We will discuss this later. Okay. So in principle, this problem is uniquely solvable, and then there is no need for additional conditions.
Okay.
But of course, there are something related to angles. Corner are very make problem very sensitive to formulation in spaces, to dress it in these spaces. So at the time I was working with Mazia and some engineers from Odessa, it's a town now in Ukraine and before in USSR, they asked him for following question. They had a program which solves directly a problem for Laplace equation. And by trivial substitution, namely, let us call minus Laplacian of u v, by trivial substitution, this problem is reduced to the iterated Laplacian, namely, it's minus delta w is equal to fw. W is a new notation for u. Is equal to zero in omega, on the omega. This problem has unique solution. You solve it, obtain W. Sorry, V here. V. And then you can solve due to this renotation. This problem for W and arrive at a solution. So this is plate problem, this is iterated Laplacian problem. They found, making calculations, that their results were completely different with experiments, so no relation at all. So that in experiment, the plate goes down here, the plate goes up, and I'm going to investigate the situation if U is equal to V or not. So rather strange question, because it's a simple renotation of unknown functions. The answer is no. And I would like to explain why. Okay. First, simple explanation. Both solutions here lives in H1. This problem is uniquely solvable in Sobolev space H1, which means that this integral is bounded. V and W. But this problem is solved in H2. Which means that integral over omega u, gradient u, and second gradient, collection of second order derivative, bounded. This guy, of course, is equivalent to the energy, elastic energy of this plate. So, and of course, everything is hidden here. Here we search for a solution in H2, and here we find the solution in H1. What is important is that this problem has two different settings. One is in H1, and one is in H2. Here we have U in H2, Laplacian U in L2, according to this. And here we have W in H1, and V, which is minus delta minus V, which is Laplacian W, belongs to H1 as well. And of course, this difference appears not every time, but for concave domains. If there is concave angle, like I draw on the picture, then this is a there is different setting. If domain is if polygon is convex, then solution satisfies. Solutions coincide both. I would like to say that this trivial transform of one problem to other problem happens rather plenty times in my life when I get a paper to make a referee report on it. So I remember three papers with such mistake. Usually, for example, for cracks or for angular domains, it's worth to introduce potentials, just to reduce elasticity problem to scalar equations or something like this. And in many times, this introduction of potentials lead to misunderstanding in which space the final problem must be solved. So, I know several, at least two situations where this this mistake was published, let me say. So, and what's interesting is that reaction of mechanicians on this thing is much more solution of homogeneous problem in L2. This is crucial for constructing of self-adjoint extensions. And by the way, I forgot to mention that this problem is a very good example of extensions. Because if you start with the same idea, you impose zero near near point O for domain of the operator A, like we did on the previous lecture. Then we obtain symmetric operator, but which is not self-adjoint. If we can speak about different self-adjoint extensions. And on the blackboard here, they were written two different self-adjoint extensions of the operator, which can be expressed as a boundary value problem, which is not, I know only one example where self-adjoint extension can be expressed in terms of differential equations only, without imposing this relation, the relationship between coefficients. Okay, so the next step is to prove this formula. Now we are going to prove this formula. And the idea is the following. We cut out a ball and use Green formula in this domain with a small hole. It's not a small hole, it's a smoothened corner. So let us do this job. When I supposed to make a break? Maybe just before calculations, because it's a point. Calculation will be a bit.
We can make a break now.
Yes. How this formula appears? How we can calculate the coefficient C capital at this point? Okay. So we integrate by parts, and we write that integral over omega delta. Delta is the radius of domain of the hole here. F zeta is equal to integral over omega delta minus, better to write, minus delta u zeta plus u delta zeta. This is f and this is zero. So I made nothing, only changed. Now we integrate by parts, we use a Green formula to obtain that this integral is equal to integral over d omega delta minus d n u zeta minus u d n zeta, d n zeta. D n denotes the normal derivative. Function u and function zeta are equal to zero everywhere except this arc, because they solve the problem with the homogeneous Dirichlet conditions. So this is equal, and dn here, dn is minus dr on this curve. So we obtain that this is the integral from minus, from theta, from zero to theta, delta, this is the radius, and here stands zeta dr u minus u dr zeta, d phi. So So what I have done, I have taken into account that minus dn is just dr. Instead of dsx on the arc, I wrote that this is equal to delta d phi, which is true. Now we have to put asymptotic formulae for zeta and for u. So it's delta integral from 0 to theta. Zeta is r minus pi over theta sin pi over theta phi d over dr r pi over theta. And I forgot to write here C, the coefficient. Sin pi over theta phi minus CR pi over theta sin pi over theta phi d over dr r minus pi over theta sin pi over theta phi d phi. Plus points. I don't want to make exact calculations because they otherwise I have to write too much. Those are insufficient terms, which appear due to differentiation of this function and also remainder of representation of V, and so on. So those will disappear when delta tends to zero. We will do the same job as we did on previous lecture. We will send finally delta to zero. So now we can calculate this thing and write here the result. So it's delta C. Now what we have here? R in power pi over theta with minus, R in power pi over theta minus 1, because we need to differentiate. So finally we arrive at R in power minus 1. The same here, because pi over theta here, but minus pi over theta here, and also minus 1 due to differentiation. So we have here delta minus 1, because R is equal to delta. Then integral from 0 to theta. What we have here? While differentiating, they appear pi over theta. And then we have sin. Here minus. And while differentiating this, they appear minus pi over theta. And again, sin pi over theta phi squared with plus and sufficient terms. Now we can calculate the result. So deltas disappear. So we have C. Then they appear 2 pi over theta. From here and from here, you see that minus multiplied with minus will give us plus. And integral from 0 to theta sin pi over theta phi squared d phi. And this integral is equal to half length of integration. So that finally we have c 2 pi performing the limit passage. We arrive at this formula. So, theorem is proved. Such formula is weight function exists for mechanics, for problems in mechanics, in particular It's a way to calculate stress intensity factors in crack tips. So it's a rather huge instrument tool to do this job. So we are equipped with these two results, and now we can investigate the problem. I mean the problem which I discussed at the very beginning of the lecture.
So maybe the right space is not even H2.
What do you mean by right space?
Not the right space, the same solution can be in larger space than H2, but smaller than H1. Because the problem is just is the that some derivative with respect to R in
some. One can put this problem into Sobolev-Slobodevsky space. And so pi over.
So in polar coordinates, anyway, there is some difference between r and theta and phi.
Just a moment. I would like to answer your question. S smaller than pi over theta minus 1. So solution belongs to Sobolev-Slobodevsky space with S, the exponent S, smaller than pi over theta minus 1. Plus one. It's wider than H1, but more narrow than H2. And this R in power pi over theta shows that this is.
Okay.
What I would like to mention that the first result in this direction is due to Birman and Skvartsov. They are from St. Petersburg. It's 57, something like this. They proved they found the defect index for operator Laplacian in concave domain in H2. So, and the index was 1:1. So, just reflecting this. Okay. So we are equipped with two theorems, and now I'm going to make a reduction. And I would like to make short notice of this theorem on the left upper corner, because I need some space in order to make this reduction. Time is running incredibly quick. So, theorem one, that V is equal to CR. So, it's rather short notation, only just to have in mind. And this is in H2, and this is in H1. And theorem two is that C is equal to 1 over pi integral over omega of f zeta dx, and zeta belongs to H2. So those are our observations we have made to theorems. Let us start with this problem again. We want to make this notation. But we need to understand in which space this solution lives. V, not solution, but function V lives. And the only space is this one. Because solution U has a finite energy, and this can be shortly written as this conclusion. So, differentiating twice function U, we get function from L2. So this is the case. This means that we need to solve the problem minus delta V is equal to F. V is equal to zero in omega. We need to solve this problem in L2. And this is the general solution. It is solution from H1. This is a function, the only solution of the homogeneous problem in L2, and this is a unknown coefficient. So this is a general solution. This is the difference between reduction scheme we are doing now in comparison with the reduction scheme on the right, because there was no such term. Now, for function U itself, we have minus delta U is equal to V, and U is equal to zero in omega on V omega. We need to find a solution in H2. We know the solution of Kirchhoff problem is in H2. At the same time, theorem 1 declares that U is equal to C R pi over alpha sin pi over alpha theta plus U wave. This is in H2, but this not in H2. So the only way to correct the situation is to impose this condition. This condition, due to theorem 2, reads integral over omega zeta v dx is equal to zero. So if we are lucky to satisfy this condition, then coefficient is zero and we really have a solution in H2. Okay? Now let us insert this representation into this integral. Then we have integral over omega d zeta squared dx plus integral over omega v zero zeta dx zero. Nothing but insertion. Because this integral is not zero, it's not
some
trivial
coefficient
function.
Or projection.
Sorry?
Some projection coefficient.
Yes. So, if you put here just this term, then we arrive at the solution in H2. This is the correct reduction scheme. Really, one can use Laplacian solver to find solution of this plate problem, but only in this way. Yeah. Okay, I left few minutes to comment for the case of, I like this very much, I'm sorry, for several angles,
uh-huh.
Because it's because.
Because you were asked about this.
Yes, from engineers.
From engineers.
It's a great fun to be asked and to find a good correct answer. So it's a rare situation in life. So what happens if you have many return back to this problem. So if you have many angles, then you have solution U, solution V, we didn't know what it is by U, is equal to sum Cj, j from 1 to j. It is necessary to put here cutoff function, which equals to 1 at the vicinity of the corresponding angular point, and 0 everywhere. And then Rj, it's a polar coordinate system near to this, to a tip of an angle. Theta j, it's the opening of this angle. And then sin pi over theta j phi j plus v wave of x. This is in H2, and this is the terms. We have to satisfy J capital conditions. What we have at hand? We have at hand zeta J, which is again cutoff function R minus P over theta J sin pi theta J phi J plus zeta correspondingly, we search for B here in the form, in the same notation. Let us now change it. No, it's not good. Okay, this is a general formula. Let us write it for you. We have to take V of x as V0 of x again. It's a solution in H1 plus sum with unknown coefficients zeta j. Now, instead of one compatibility condition, they appear k compatibility condition, j compatibility condition. And instead of this formula, we get the following. Sum from j of 1 to j, b j, zeta j, zeta k, k from 1 to j. So this is the formula. And now we need to solve system of algebraic equation. And solution as a vector, as a column, is given by this formula. B1 Bj is equal to m minus 1 g1 gj, where g capital gj gk is integral over minus v0 zeta j dx. And now the point which I like very much, and m has the following entries. And this is Gram matrix. It's a Gram matrix, which is symmetric positive, definite, so it is invertible. In any case, you can solve this problem. Okay. So I was rather quick. Maybe there will be questions because I don't want to start a new topic.
Enough.
Okay, next time I will speak about thin domains, elastic rods, but in representation of scalar operator, and I would like to show some unpredictable effects when oscillation is located. So this is my idea for next two talks. Okay, so thank you very much for your